Now, my colleague, we will speak about AIDS infection, about etiology, epidemiology, about clinic, laboratory diagnostic and treatments, AIDS infection and opportunistic infection. Let's begin our lecture. And AIDS infection is an infection which characterized by destruction of immune cells, increasing of immunodeficiency syndrome, activation of opportunistic infection, development of visceral and disseminated forms of opportunistic infection, which cause the polyorgans insufficiency and death of the patients. And now you see the structure of the viruses. You see such components of the virus. It is a retrovirus, RNA virus, and the virus of AIDS characterized by such structure elements. For example, membrane of the virus, core proteins of the virus, enzyme systems, and genes of the virus. So, membrane of the virus, it is envelope, yes, and consists of some glycoproteins, GP41, GP120, GP160. So, it is very important because we must use those information for diagnostic of AIDS infection. Next, core proteins, it is group-specific antigen, enzyme systems, for example, polymerase and integrase of the virus, and genes of the virus. There are three structures genes and three regulator genes. Let's speak about main ways of transmissions of the virus. For example, blood contacts, transfusion, transplantation, syringe, congenital and sexual ways of transmissions. And effects of transmission of the virus is blood, sperm, secretion from cervical canal, and woman's milk. So all biological substrate contain the virus. Blood, sperm, secretion of cervical canal, and woman's milk. You see the structure of the virus, you see envelope and GP on the picture. Next, core proteins, group-specific antigen, transcriptase of the virus, integrase of the virus, and RNA of the virus, and genes of the virus. Let's speak about pathogenesis of AIDS infection, pathogenesis. And now we must remember that virus penetrate to blood and it causes the formation of virusemia. Then virus penetrate to immune cells and express receptor or membrane of immune cells. Yes, and so virus characterized by activation of enzymes of the virus, transcriptase and integrase of the virus, and at first activation of transcriptase of the virus, which caused activation synthesis of RNA of the AIDS virus in cytoplasm of immune cells. Then synthesize another RNA of the virus, and then RNA of the virus integrate to immune cells. Formation of integrative forms of infection. And then the immune cells begin produce the virus in cytoplasm, in ribosome, synthesis of RNA of the virus, and then excretion new viruses to blood. So it's characterized by activation of infection process, synthesis of new viruses, increasing of concentration of the virus in blood, higher level of virusemia. So it's characterized by acute phase of infection. So some of immune cells are destructed, and this is characterized by increasing of immunodeficiency syndrome. But a virus is very changeable, and so some of antibodies don't recognize infected cells because virus cause the progressive forms of infection. Infected new cells, infected neurocyte, immune cells, glandular cells, epithelium of blood vessels. So it causes the progressive of infection. So it's characterized by decreasing of the level of immune cells. So immune cells are disrupted by the virus activity. So some of the virus characterized by increasing of synthesis of antibodies. Yes, activation of humoral immune response, but antibodies, humoral immune cells, don't recognize infected cells, and it causes the formation of weak immune response and non-effective humoral immune response. So it causes the progressive of AIDS infection, infected new cells, and involve different organs. So we spoke about decreasing of the level of immune cells, decreasing of the level T lymphocytes, increasing of immunodeficiency syndrome, and so it characterizes activation of opportunistic infection. Because, for example, virus, bacterial, parasitic opportunistic infection. For example, if we speak about virus opportunistic infection, we speak about herpetic infection, cytomegalovirus infection, Epstein-Barr virus, so they are herpetic infection, polyoma virus, Papova virus, so virus activation and cause the destruction of different organs, internal organs, for example, liver, lung, brain, so formation of disseminated forms of opportunistic infection. Then activation of bacterial infection. So all endogenic bacteria are activated and formation of pneumonia, cholangitis, meningitis, meningoencephalitis. So focus inflammatory alteration of different organs, then generalization of infection and formation of prolonged forms of bacteremia, general forms of bacterial infection, sepsis, formation of metastatic focus of infection, and polyorgans insufficiency. Then parasitic forms of opportunistic infection because amebiasis, balanitidiasis, gelminthiasis, it's characterized by activation of opportunistic infection. At first we indication local forms of opportunistic infection, then we diagnosis visceral forms, for example, pneumonia, hepatitis, nephritis, gastroenteritis. Then it's called the formation of general disseminated forms of opportunistic infection, and it's characterized by very progressive immunodeficiency syndrome when the level of CD4 of immune cells is less than 200 in 1 microliter. So, some of bacteria and viruses penetrate to hematoencephalic barrier and cause the formation of meningitis, meningoencephalitis, neurological syndrome, paresis, paralysis. Sometimes it was characterized by destruction of retina of the patients, panophthalmitis, chorioretinitis. Yes, so there is pathogenesis of AIDS infection. So, opportunistic infection caused the formation of general disseminated forms, and it caused the formation of polyorgan insufficiency and formation of death of the patients. So, what mechanism characterized by progressive of AIDS infection? So, some scientists indicated some such factors, for example, tolerance of invasion of virus characterized by mutations of genes of receptor CCR5, CXCR4, CCL5. So, it's characterized by prolonged forms, favorable variants of AIDS infection. There is no progressions of AIDS infection. So, and very quickly, progressive of infection characterized by mutations of genes interleukin 10, interleukin 6. So, it's characterized by very progressive variants of opportunistic infection, polyorgan insufficiency, and death of the patient. You see the spread of AIDS infection in the world. So, hyper-endemic region is Africa. So, more than 15% of population infected by AIDS virus. So we spoke about etiology, epidemiology, pathogenesis, and now we will speak about clinical classification and clinic of AIDS infection. So you see there are 5 stages of AIDS infection. For example, let's speak about those phase. The first stage, the first phase is stage of incubation. Stage of incubation lasts from some week up to some months. Next, second stage is the stage of primary manifestation. It is acute phase of AIDS infection. Acute phase characterized by mononucleosic-like syndrome. It's characterized by higher fever, intoxication, syndrome of tonsillitis, catarrhal syndrome, rhinitis, pharyngitis, tonsillitis. We can reveal purulent patch or necrotic patch on tonsils. General lymphadenopathia, increasing of lymphatic nodes of different groups, lymphatic groups. Yes. So it is acute phase. It is primary manifestation. Sometimes hepatosplenomegaly and exanthemas, rash on the skin. So, but there are some variant of acute phase. For example, 3 variant. Asymptomatical variant, There is no clinic, there is no symptoms, and it's characterized by seroconversions. Seroconversions, so manifestation, indication of antibodies to the virus. Indication antibodies of the virus. Next, acute phase without opportunistic infection. Acute phase without opportunistic infection. It's characterized by clinic of mononucleosis-like syndrome. Yes, we spoke. It's characterized by the fever, flu-like syndrome, catarrhal syndrome, prolonged fever, maybe. It may be subfebrility temperature, febrility temperature, syndrome of tonsillitis, necrotic patch, purulent patch on tonsils, general lymphadenopathia, hepatosplenomegaly, rash on the skin. So it is symptoms of infection of mononucleosis. But there is no opportunistic infection in those phase. Next variant, acute phase with opportunistic infection. So in those patients, the indication mononucleosis-like syndrome and symptoms of opportunistic infection. For example, herpetic infection. For example, herpetic rash on the skin. Herpetic stomatitis. It is local forms of opportunistic infection. So, pyodermia, streptodermia. So, destruction involve to skin, to pathological process. Formation of dermatitis, stomatitis. Yes, and sometimes subfebrility temperature, prolonged subfebrility temperature. It is acute phase with opportunistic infection. Sometimes pneumonia, for example, hepatitis, cholangitis, nephritis, gastroenteritis. In acute phase of AIDS infection. So acute phase lasts from some weeks up to some months. We reveal latent phase of infection, latent phase, asymptomatical phase, latent phase. It characterizes, there is no clinic, there is no symptoms, but virus causes destruction, different cells and immune cells. It causes the increasing of immunodeficiency syndrome, increasing of destruction of immune cells. Also, sometimes in latent phase, we observe subfebrility temperature, asthenic syndrome, increasing of general lymphatic nodes, lymphadenopathia. Yes. And latent phase characterized by from some months up to some years. Then decreasing of immune cells characterized by activation of opportunistic infection. So, and fourth stage is phase of opportunistic infection, activation of endogenic virus, bacteria, and parasites. We must remember that activation of endogenic infection and formation of oncological process, formation of malignant cancer of different organs, for example, malignant lymphoma, sarcoma Kaposi, those phase, because decreasing of immune response, decreasing of the level of T lymphocytes, and activation of malignization of different organs. Let's speak about those phase. So it is local forms of opportunistic infection. It characterized by the fever of the patients, asthenic syndrome, general lymphadenopathia, and formation of dermatitis, rash on the skin, herpetic rash on the skin, papular rash, maybe it is streptodermia, pyodermia, stomatitis, tonsillitis, herpetic stomatitis, necrotic stomatitis of the patients. So it characterizes there is no marked decreasing of immune cells in those phase. So the level of immune cells, immune cells is more than 500 cells in 1 microliter. Next, for stage, it is stage of visceral forms of opportunistic infection. Visceral forms of opportunistic infection is characterized by activation of endogenic infection and involve internal organs, formation of visceral forms. Immune cells in those forms is in interval 499 up to 200 cells in 1 microliter. And in those phase we indication pneumonia, for example, hepatitis, nephritis, arthritis, so ophthalmitis, formation in those patients. It may be viral pneumonia or bacterial pneumonia, or maybe gastroenteritis by caused by viruses, bacteria, candidosic of pneumonia, candidosic gastroenteritis, so in those phase. Next, fourth stage of opportunistic infection characterized by formation of dissemination forms and formation of dissemination process, general forms of opportunistic infection, which cause the formation of polyorgans insufficiency. You see, general forms, it is AIDS Marcus infection, AIDS associated complex, or AIDS Marcus infection. For example, general forms of herpetic infections, polyomavirus infections, toxoplasmosis, cryptosporidiosis, candidiasis, atypical mycobacteriosis, Kaposi's sarcoma, malignant lymphoma, leukocyte pneumonia. Formation of general forms of those infections. We can detail of all nosological forms. And for example, general forms of herpetic infection characterized by herpetic rash on the skin, so vesical rash. Formation of dermatitis, tonsillitis, esophagitis, for example, dysphagia, formation of gastroenteritis, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea, and herpetic elements on mucus of stomach, of intestinal. Herpetic pneumonia, formation of respiratory insufficiency, and formation of interstitial pneumonia of the patient. Yes, some of viruses penetrate or of gametoencephalic barrier and formation of meningitis, meningoencephalitis, chronic cramps, paresis paralysis, alteration or inflammational alteration of the liquor. Yes, and polyorgans insufficiency, formation of death of the patients. Cytomegalovirus too. So virus penetrates to different organs, formation of pneumonia, hepatitis, it's characterized by jaundice, cetosis, liver insufficiency. So cytomegalovirus causes the gastroenteritis, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea. So virus causes the formation of meningitis, meningoencephalitis, neurological syndrome, So, in cytomegalovirus infection. Herpes virus number 6, yes. Herpes virus Epstein-Barr 2. So, it characterized by destruction of epithelium, hyperplasia of lymphoid tissue, stomatitis, tonsillitis, pneumonia. Viruses penetrate to hematoencephalic barrier and cause the neurological syndrome, formation of meningoencephalitis. So they are herpes virus. Next, polyoma virus or papoma virus cause the destruction of central nervous system, formation of meningitis, meningoencephalitis, so tonic cramps, clonic cramps, paresis, and paralysis. Mental disorders, so emotional disorders of the patient. Higher fever, neurological syndrome, syndrome of meningoencephalitis. Next, toxoplasmosis. Toxoplasmosis is parasitic opportunistic infection. Infection agent is Toxoplasma gondii, which is oral mechanism of transmission. So it causes the formation of acute and chronic forms of infection. Maybe transplacent mechanism of transmission of toxoplasmosis. So and what clinic? For example, it's characterized by acute forms characterized by the fever, hepatosplenomegaly, roseolus rash. So there is typhoid-like variants of toxoplasmosis. In patients with immunodeficiency syndrome, toxoplasma causes the formation of pneumonia, respiratory insufficiency, cause formation of hepatitis, syndrome of Jaundice and Sertoli's. It penetrates to hematoencephalic barrier and formation of meningitis, meningoencephalitis, paresis, paralysis, clonic cramps. Toxoplasma causes penetrate to retina and cause the formation of panophthalmitis of the patients. Cryptosporidiosis is characterized by destruction of gastrointestinal syndrome. Infection agent is cryptosporidia, it is parasitic infection too. Oral mechanism of transmission. And cryptosporidia cause formation, destruction of mucosa of gastrointestinal syndrome, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, secretory, exudation diarrhea, formation of gastroenteritis, dehydration, sometimes formation of pneumonic forms, penetration to the lung and cause the destruction of the lung, parasitic pneumonia, respiratory insufficiency. So next, candidiasis is opportunistic infection too. And in the patients with immunodeficiency syndrome, on the fourth stage of AIDS infection, formation of general forms of candidiasis. It is sepsis, and candidosic sepsis. So, and formation of metastatic focus of infection in different organs. Formation of metastatic focus in the lung, in the liver, in the brain. Formation of candidosic gastroenteritis, formation of candidosic patch on mucosa of stomach, intestinal, syndrome of gastroenteritis, formation of pneumonia, respiratory insufficiency, infiltration of the lung. Some of bacteria penetrate to the brain and formation of meningoencephalitis. So atypical mycobacteriosis characterized by destruction of the lung, lymphadenopathia, destruction of the lung, respiratory insufficiency, malignant lymphoma, leukocyte pneumonia characterized by formation of destruction alveolitis, respiratory distress syndrome, and formation of destruction alveolitis and respiratory insufficiency. Sarcoma kaposi characterized by activation of virus, herpes virus 2 and herpes virus number 8, which caused the destruction of endothelium of blood vessels, capillaries, and formation of extravasates, formation of elements on the skin. And in the patients with immunodeficiency syndrome, it caused the formation of visceral forms in different organs, for example, disseminated metastatic form, metastatic forms in the lung, in the brain, in the liver, which caused the formation polyorgans insufficiency. So such opportunistic infection, we indication in 4 stages of infection. It is a stage of dissemination forms of opportunistic infection. And it's characterized by decreasing of concentration of CD cells in the blood is less than 200 cells in 1 microliter. So it is stage of opportunistic infection. So we observe not only opportunistic infection, we can observe formation sepsis, yes, which caused by staphylococcus, streptococcus, pneumococcus, pseudomonas aeruginosa. So different bacteria cause visceral and general forms of infection. And next 5th stage of AIDS infection characterized by it is terminal stage when CD T lymphocytes characterized by decreasing is less than 50 cells in 1 microliter. So the indication combination forms of opportunistic infection, combination forms, for example, combination forms, for example, viruses and bacteria, parasitic and bacteria, for example, virus and bacteria cause the destruction of respiratory system, formation of combined forms of pneumonia. So viruses, bacteria cause the destruction of formation of meningoencephalitis. And so virus, bacteria, and parasites cause the destruction of gastrointestinal syndrome. And the T lymphocytes is less than 50 cells in 1 microliter. So there is classification and clinical variants of AIDS infection. So let's speak about diagnostic of laboratory diagnostic. But what clinic and anamnesis it is very important for diagnostic of infection. Yes, it is a group of risk of AIDS infection. For example, drug addicts, the patient with a social group of population. Yes, the patient with tuberculosis, the patient of the patients with Lewis, for example, the patient with serological hepatitis, hepatitis B, C, D, what indication for examination of the patients of AIDS infection? It is epidemiological criterion and clinical criterion. So epidemiological criterion, we spoke, yes, it is drug addicts, sexual contact with the patients with AIDS infection, homosexual, heterosexual, the patients of asocial groups, the patients with tuberculosis, the patients with hepatitis B, C, D. Yes, and the patients from endemic region from AIDS infection. And clinical indication for diagnostic of examination of AIDS infection, it is the patient with prolonged fever, the patient with prolonged forms of infection, prolonged forms of pneumonia, gastroenteritis, prolonged forms of respiratory insufficiency, diarrhea, different variants of patients with prolonged variants of rash of the skin, lymphadenopathy, the patients with mononucleosic-like syndrome. So we must remember the clinic of acute forms of AIDS infection. It is mononucleosic-like syndrome, the fever, syndrome of tonsillitis, lymphadenopathy, hepatosplenomegaly, atypical mononuclears in blood. Symptoms of meningitis, meningoencephalitis, paresis, paralysis. Symptoms, clinic of sepsis. It is clinic of opportunistic infection. All those indication for examination of AIDS infection. And all those patients, we can administer such diagnostic test, for example, ELISA methods for indication of antibodies in blood. So antibodies to GP, you remember the structure of membrane of the virus, envelope of the virus, yes? Envelope, we indication antibodies to those components. Then methods of immunoblotting, when we indication some antibodies of membrane of the virus. GP41, GP120, and GP160. Then polymerase reaction when we indication virus in blood. By polymerase reaction. Then we indication immunogram, so we indication the level of immune cells. Yes, and we know that in clinic of opportunistic infection, in disseminated forms of opportunistic infection, decreasing of the level of immune cells is less than 200 cells in 1 microliter. Diagnostic of opportunistic infection. So, for example, diagnostic of herpes virus infection. We indication herpes virus in blood. Polymerase reaction. We indication the virus from saliva. We indication antibodies to herpes virus by ELISA methods. Indication of bacterial forms of opportunistic infection. For example, gemoculture, yes. Copra culture, urine culture, mucus culture. And diagnostic of parasitic forms of opportunistic infection. Microscopy of feces. When we indication gelmints, amoeba, balantidia, cryptosporidia. Let's speak about treatments of the patients with AIDS infection. You see, there are many groups of antiviral methods of treatments, group of antiviral medicates. The first group of antiviral medicates, it is group of nucleosides inhibitor of transcriptase. There is abacavir, nicavir, combivir. Those group is inhibitor of enzymes, transcriptase, and block replication cycle of the virus in immune cells. Next group, non-nucleosides inhibitor of transcriptase, Viramun. It blocks transcriptase 2. Prevention, replication 2. Next group, inhibitor of protease of the virus. Indinavir, Sacavinavir, Calliandra. Inhibitor of protease of the virus. So protease of the virus, it is activation, replication of the virus. So inhibitor of factors of confluence of the virus, fusion. Block of factors of confluence of the virus and prevention and prevention infected cells and replication of the virus. Inhibitor of integrase of the virus, for example, raltegravir, it characterized by block enzymes of integrase and formation, integrative phase of infection. Next, block of receptor of immune cells. Block of receptor of immune cells, CCR5. It is maraviroc. So block recognizing immune cells and infected cells. And antiligand, so antiligand of the virus, which block of the receptor GP, yes, block receptor GP of the virus, so and those virus cannot integrate, replicate in immune cells. So there are different mechanisms of those virus, because at first we administer combined antiviral treatments. It is the first, second and third groups of the virus. So, for example, abacavir, viramun, yes, and calletra. So it is initial treatments. And then we observe the patients, we indication the concentration of the virus. If we observe the decreasing of concentration of the virus, and immune stability of the patients, improvement of conditions, of the patients. So we continue those treatment during many months and years. If we see progressive of infection, we think about tolerance of the virus of those medicates, because we administer another group, for example, reserve groups, inhibitors of factors of confluence of the virus, inhibitor of integrase of the virus, and block the receptor of the virus. So such groups of medicates. And antiviral treatments must continue forever, all the life of the patients. If we stop antiviral treatment, finish treatment, it's called the progressive of AIDS infection. And now let's speak about treatments of opportunistic infection. Yes, treatments of opportunistic infection. For example, herpetic infection, we administer Valtrex, famciclovir, sometimes oral forms, or intravenously we can administer acyclovir, Valtrex, famciclovir. For example, dose of Valtrex, 500 milligram to time per day. So during 7 days. If it is visceral forms, it is intravenously forms of medicates. For example, if we treat the patient with cytomegalovirus viral infection, the main medicates is cimivin or ganciclovir intravenously. Cimivin or ganciclovir intravenously. Polyomaviral infection, it is interferons treatments. Interferons alpha, interferons gamma interferons, immunoglobulins intravenously. Toxoplasmosis, it is parasitic infection. We administer tindurin, plus rovamycin, clindamycin, so combined treatments, sulfalen, so such medicates in toxoplasmosis. Тиндурин плюс сульфадиазин плюс клиндамицин. Or in pregnancy woman, for example, ровамицин. So for inactivation in cases of activation of toxoplasmosis. So those treatments we combine with antiviral treatments, yes. And after antiviral treatments, we administer another groups of medicates. Cryptosporidiosis, we administer rovamycin, spiramycin for those treatments. In patients with candidiasis, we administer Farcan, amphotericin B, diflucan. In candidiasis, we administer Farcan, amphotericin B, амфоглюкамин. Atypical mycobacteriosis, рифампицин of the patients. Kaposi sarcoma, it is chemotherapy. Malignant lymphoma, chemotherapy. Leukocyte pneumonia is interferon treatments. So, such methods of treatments of opportunistic infection. And treatments of opportunistic infection, we continue for stabilization of clinical laboratory findings. So let's speak about some variants of infection. So sometimes we indication three groups of infection of the patients with AIDS infection. Typical progressions, hyperprogressions, and non-progressions. What does it mean, typical progressions? There are the patients with which polyorgans insufficiency and opportunistic infection formation after 8 years of infection. Sometimes 8, sometimes 10 years after beginning of infection. So it is phase of opportunistic infection. Hyperprogression of AIDS infection when opportunistic infection and disseminated forms of opportunistic infection formation from 2 up to 5 years. So it is very progressive variants of infection. And opportunistic infection manifestation very quickly in those patients. And non-progressions of the patients, which characterize the prolonged and favorable variants of infection. There is no progressive of infection. There are 15% of those patients. So, and many years, many months, many years, more than 10 years, the patient keep stabilization of clinic and there is no progressive of opportunistic infection. And concentration of the virus in interval, for example, from 50 up to 2,000 viruses in 1 milliliter. So it is little, very small concentration of the virus. And higher level of immune cells, so the level of CD lymphocytes, more than 500 cells in 1 microliter, many years, more than 10 years. So it is non-progressors of the patients. What methods of prevention of AIDS infection? Prophylactic of sexual transmission, prophylactic of blood transmission, prophylactic of congenital forms of infection, fighting against sexual immorality, fighting against drug addicts, and early diagnostic of infection and early treatment of AIDS infection, and creation of vaccine of the virus. Because we must remember indication for examination of AIDS infection. Yes, we spoke about epidemiological criterion and clinical criterion of diagnostic of AIDS infection. Very important in early stage of infection, diagnostic of AIDS infection and administer antiviral treatment. So, because it is there is no progressive variants of infection. So, some picture characterized by different syndrome when we reveal in AIDS infection. Mononucleosic-like syndrome, you see, the fever, syndrome of tonsillitis, fibrinic patch on tonsils, necrotic patch on tonsils, dipyrimia of fossa, general lymphadenopathia, increasing of lymphatic nodes of different groups of the patients, hepatosplenomegaly, yes, rash on the skin, papular rash, macular rash on the skin. Localization of sarcoma Kaposi, you see such dark elements on mucus, such elements on the skin, you see dark elements. So in sarcoma Kaposi, destruction of blood vessels and formation of extravasates and formation of those elements on the skin. In AIDS infection, in progressive of the AIDS infection, it's characterized by destruction of blood vessels of different organs, metastatic forms, metastasis of the lung, metastasis of the brain, different visceral forms, and formation of polyorgan insufficiency. So, elements of sarcoma Kaposi in the skin. Disseminated forms of sarcoma Kaposi, which involve internal organs, brain, so you see skin elements of sarcoma Kaposi. Malignant lymphoma, different localization of malignant lymphoma in the visceral organs, in regional lymphatic nodes, in the brain, so very progressive of such syndrome and formation of metastatic forms. Herpetic rash on the skin, you see, herpetic eruption, herpetic rash, vesicle rash on the skin. Group of vesicle elements, which is herpes zoster involve of nerve endings of the patients. Yes, it is herpes zoster. Destruction of epithelium and penetration to nerve endings, formation of sometimes neuralgia, hyperemia, edema of skin, and formation of vesicle on the skin. Herpetic rash, vesicle rash. Yes, you see spot, papule, vesicle, serosal exudation from vesicle, sometimes formation of pustules, vesicle rash, herpetic rash. So next opportunistic infection, candidiasis, involve different organs, and you see stomatitis, pharyngitis, tonsillitis, and so. Those elements on the lips, on the tongue, in visceral forms, in formation of pneumonia, sepsis, meningoencephalitis, in candidosic sepsis. So, candidosic pattern on the tongue. So, congenital forms of herpetic infection. Yes, in pregnancy woman with AIDS infection. So, prevention of infected the fetus in the patients, because in 12 weeks of pregnancy, the woman we must administer antiviral treatment for prophylactic of infected the fetus and formation of congenital forms of AIDS infection. Thank you for your time. Goodbye.